welcome to the first round of today's National Television English Parliamentary Debate Competition. Ladies and gentlemen, the format of the parliamentary debate competition differs from the traditional style. In this system, there is a government party and an opposition party. The motion is placed in the House by the Prime Minister, who is also the leader of the House. The role of the opposition is also to place constructive arguments against the bill. Today's motion before the House is, Sark promised but has achieved more failure than success. Majid Zarina Foundation School and College, Shariatpur is representing the government side, and South Point School and College, Dhaka is representing the opposition side. The government side is being represented by Sabrina Zahan Shobha of Majid Zarina Foundation School and College, who is the Prime Minister and Leader of the House. Zuhairia Akhtar is a member of the Cabinet and is in charge of Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Sohana Khan Laz is a member of the Treasury Bench. The opposition bench is being represented by Maniha Zahan Haq of South Point School and College, who is the leader of the opposition. Ahona Bhomik is the deputy leader of the opposition. Naushin Zahan is a member of the opposition bench. The honorable adjudicators of this session are Al-Jamal Mustafa Sindaini, Assistant Professor, Department of Sociology, Bangladesh University of Professional and Eminent Debater; Dr. Zebun Nessa, Associate Professor and Chairman, Department of Public Administration, Jahangirnagar University, Joint Secretary, Peshajibi Nari Samaj; Anisul Rahman, Deputy Director, Bangladesh Public Service Commission Secretariat, Dhaka; Hassan Mahmud Biplab, Lawyer and Eminent Debater. The Honorable Speaker of the House is Mr. Ali Ahmed, former member, National Board of Revenue and CEO, Bangladesh Foreign Trade Institute. Before the House starts its proceeding, let me inform you about the order and time allocation of each debater. Prime Minister, 4 minutes; Leader of the Opposition, 5 minutes; Member of the Cabinet, 5 minutes; Deputy Leader of the Opposition, 5 minutes; Member of the Treasury Bench, 5 minutes; Member of the Opposition Bench, 5 minutes. The Opposition Leader will get another 3 minutes for rebuttal, and the Prime Minister will get the last 4 minutes to wind up his party's stand. All the members of the competing teams, the adjudicators, the invited guests, and other members of the audience will comprise the members of the House. I now most humbly request the Honorable Speaker to start today's proceeding. Honorable Speaker, please.
May I now invite the government side to please place their motion before the House.
Honorable Speaker, as the Prime Minister, I am going to establish the motion that Sark from its birth has achieved more failure than success. Honorable Speaker, after the presentation, it has to be defined first. To define today's motion, I would like to impose priority to some words that are Sark and the standpoints of its success and failure. Honorable Speaker, at the very outset, I would like to define what is Sark. After that, as a standpoint of success and failure, I will highlight the goals and objectives of Sark. And then, I will establish my point, presenting exact instances, data and information. Honorable Speaker, Sark is an association which stands for South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. The member countries of Sark are Bangladesh, India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Nepal, Bhutan, Maldives and Afghanistan. Sark started functioning from 1985. The guiding goals and objectives of Sark are, firstly, to encourage active collaboration in economic, social, cultural, technical and scientific fields; secondly, to strengthen collective resilience; thirdly, to establish good relations with other international organizations for the development of member countries; fourthly, to increase people-to-people contact and making brotherhood and share information among the Sark countries; fifthly, to respect the principles of sovereign equality and territorial integrity; sixthly, not to interfere in other countries' affairs and mutual benefit. Honorable Speaker, I would like to draw your attention that if Sark becomes able to reach its maximum goals and objectives, then we will say that Sark has achieved more success than failure. But if Sark fails in maximum goals and objectives, then we will say that SALT has achieved more failure than success. Honorable Speaker, now I will talk about my first 2 points. Honorable Speaker, let us observe the present situation of the first objective of SALT. Honorable Speaker, according to the Japan-based development organization JICA, since 46 years of our independence, it has built 73 large and small bridges and 950-kilometer elevated express highway in Bangladesh. According to the official page of World Bank, it has invested 1,500,000 crore since our independence. Honorable Speaker, Rukpur Atomic Electricity Project, Dhaka Elevated Expressway Metro Rail, Paira Seaport, Sonadia Seaport, Ghumtum Valley Station, Matharibari Power Project are some instances of foreign projects. But Honorable Speaker, we don't get any kind of assistance of SALT in any development project. In this regard, SALT has reached the top of its inability that proves nothing but the failing picture of SALT. Honorable Speaker, according to the official page of WHO, it has donated $11.5 million for the year. Likewise, UNGP has given 1,530,000 as education assistance for children and women education. But Honorable Speaker, it cannot but be said that SALT or any other member countries of SALT has not done so. That is done by the other foreign states. It is nothing but the failing picture of SALT. Honorable Speaker, according to the news of BTV, NTV, ATN News, the Delhi Astro, Delhi Postal Malo, on 29 June 2013, Bangladesh lost Haji SP in the market of America. But Honorable Speaker, here lies my grief that when we see that the other member countries of SALT, like Pakistan, India, Maldives, and so on, are trying to grasp the market of Bangladesh instead of restoring the GSP of Bangladesh. Here, SALT has done nothing. That is why it is to be said that SALT is a failed and dead association whose defeat is demolishing it. Honorable Speaker, now I will talk about my second point. Honorable Speaker, European Union, G8, G7, and so on are providing IT development, e-management, e-gov support to their member countries. But Honorable Speaker, here lies my grief that we cannot search for oil, gas, or other resources in the sea because of less technical support. Honorable Speaker, if we got central technical support from SALT, we would have been successful. But so far, SALT has done nothing in this place. That is why it is to be said that SALT is a scorched, spoiled, and rotten body in the sea of failure that matches the proverb, "Sarbange betha, oushodh debo kotha." Honorable Speaker, I have portrayed the failing picture of SALT presenting my 2 points. And lastly, it is almost clear and proof that SALT from its birth has achieved more failure than success.
May I now invite the Honorable Leader of the Opposition.
As the Prime Minister of the House has already declared the motion, which is SALT from its birth has achieved more failure than its success. And today, standing here, I'm strongly opposing this motion. As the Prime Minister has already described the keywords of our motion, in spite of repeating the same thing, I would like to say what is success and what is failure in the perspective of SALT. If the work or activity of SALT is totally oriented to its objective and it has a positive outcome, it will be the success of SALT. And if the work or activity done by SALT are beyond its objective and it has a negative impact, it will be the failure of SALT. Today we say, yes, SALT has few failures, but the fact is, the amount of success of SALT is lot more than the failure of SALT. Today we are opposing this motion for some specific and logical grounds. Firstly, SALT is truly objective oriented, it is solely on its track. Secondly, we can't blame SALT for the wrong steps taken by its member countries. Thirdly, internal affairs and border crises is not a part of the of the objectives of SALT. Fourthly, SALT itself is a dynamic organization. And lastly, SALT emphasizes equal participation in spite of giving emphasizes only on specific countries. Firstly, I would like to say today I will show why are we opposing the motion. The deputy leader of our team will show success and successful work of SALT, and a member of our cabinet will show multidimensional work of SALT and the sectors of where SALT has worked and will summarize our motion. Firstly, I would like to say, as an active organization, SALT is working on various innumerable sectors such as agriculture, communication, health, tourism, drug abuse, women empowerment, education, sport, culture, environment, trade and commerce, poverty alleviation, and many more. Firstly, I would like to give a light on the objectives of SALT, on the charter of SALT. The objectives of SALT are totally defined and specified in the charter of SALT. And SALT is totally working according to its charter, and it is totally on its track. We cannot say SALT by such activities which is not included in the activities of SALT. On the other hand, the member of our government team are stating such activities as a failure of SALT which doesn't even include its charter, Honorable Speaker. We have to determine the success or failure of SALT by its own activities, not the activities of its member countries. The activities taken by its member countries won't affect the activities of SALT. affairs will always work according to its own goals, own objectives written in the specific charter of SAARC. First of all, I would like to say, if this say about India-Pakistan goes, yes, if this says, firstly, I would like to say, no border crisis or internal affairs is a part of charter of SAARC. Then how can they say?
Well, yes, but be very short.
My opposition leader, sir, speaks of mutual benefit, mutual cooperation, but it closed the way of negotiation. Shall I call it failure?
The thing you have said about negotiation and mutual cooperation, you will get it in my later speech. Thank you, Honorable Speaker. Firstly, I would like to say, if it doesn't include the Charter of SAARC, which is political discrimination and border crisis, then how can you say SAARC's failure by such an activity which doesn't even include its charter? On the other hand, Honorable Speaker, if we see in other ways, there are various problems among different countries of the world. These countries are members of different organizations such as ASEAN, BIMSTEC, African Union, etc. These organizations also couldn't do such a thing to eradicate the problem among their member countries totally. So if because of crisis among the member countries of SAARC, total organization SAARC as a failure, then I can say no other regional organization of the world is fruitful. Another thing I would like to up is, in spite of telling it as a failure, we can tell it as the biggest success of SAARC to bring two ever enemies of the world, India and Pakistan, in one table under one platform. Now I would like to say, if for some failures you can say whole organization SAARC as a failure, can you show us any organization in the world which is 100% successful? No, they can't, Honorable Speaker, because there is no organization in the world which can eradicate any problem in 100%. They can just take it to a tolerable level. And in this case, SAARC has succeeded to its best. Honorable Speaker, another thing I would like to light up is member, membership and geographical location of SAARC. We all know about the 8 member countries of SAARC, but besides this, countries like China, Australia, European Union, Japan, Iran, Mauritius, Myanmar, South Korea, United States are trying to collaborate with SAARC. If the whole organization of SAARC was such a failure, why would these important and developed countries of the world take to collaborate with SAARC, Honorable Speaker?
Prime Minister's side, it's the member of the cabinet in charge of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs.
Honorable Speaker, we expected a logical and proper discussion from our opposition party. But unfortunately, the opposition leader is totally distracted from the Eastern politics for the Prime Minister. They have not been able to find any unacceptable points in the presentation of the Prime Minister because SAARC failure is already an established issue. Honorable Speaker, my opposition has spoken about the observers of SAARC summit. But Honorable Speaker, I think the observers like European Union, China and Russia will form the interest because of such gradual failure. Honorable Speaker, if I compare the success presented by the opposition and the failure presented by the Prime Minister, the message can be compared with a funny example. That is, a small chicken in the face of a giant chicken anaconda. Yes, Honorable Speaker, here the chicken is the success and the giant chicken anaconda is the failure of such. Honorable Speaker, the Prime Minister of Serious House has presented a logical and time-sensitive motion before to the House. After presenting the motion, she has selected 6 points. She has already selected first 2 points, including theory, information, and logic, to establish the stability of today's motion. At this stage, I will present 2nd 2 points. Honorable Speaker, the 2nd 2 objectives of SAARC are firstly to establish
point
the information with other international organizations.
Yes, please.
And secondly,
later.
If you think the whole organization SAARC is a failure, then what do you think from which year it started its journey to failure? Thank you, Honorable Speaker.
Honorable Speaker, I was talking about the objective of SAARC. The 2nd 2 objectives of SAARC are firstly to establish good relations with other international organizations and secondly to increase people-to-people contact. Honorable Speaker, resolution begins. As far as the world after the World War II, we have seen the sign of the European Union, the Arab Maghreb Union, the Commons of the Market, the Southern African Development Community, and the Association of Southeast Asian Nations. Obviously, to all the world knows the success history of European Union and all other regional organizations. They are effective and successful because they had a strong and good relation with other international organizations. But, Honorable Speaker, will my opposition be able to show any relation of SAARC with any international organization? Definitely. SAARC is totally an isolated association. After all this, I think SAARC is not seeing a SAARC. That SAARC is
I'm alone. I'm very alone. Yes, I'm a speaker. Such is alone, such is a failure, such has no international friends. I'm a speaker. Joy addressing that Rohingya crisis has been a matter of great concern for Bangladesh for the last year. Recently, it was put eyes on the pages of newspapers, on the news sites like social media, Facebook or Twitter, on the display of television. We see news and views about serious condition of Rohingya living in Myanmar. Other speaker, according to the survey of United Nations, about 4,23,000 people have entered into Bangladesh from Rakhine within last 3 days in August and September. Other speaker, according to the Daily Punjab, the government of Bangladesh is trying to overcome the Rohingya crisis. Incapability, meaninglessness, and helplessness are 100% clear. As a member of SAC, Bangladesh should have been helped by SAC. But it is a matter of great show that SAC has no country except at all. Our speaker, I will fix another guiding objective of SAC, that is, SAC will induce people to give a contact. SAC will make brotherhood. Our speaker, it will not be exaggerated if I say about SAC. Empty vessels transfer. Haircut is nothing but an empty vessel. My opposition, the point of people to give a contact at making brotherhood is nothing but a farce, it's nothing but a false state. Our speaker, joy attention that all the people of the world know about Bhutan and Marshall's border killings at the Indus Border Security Force. I will speak and let us look at a tragic incident. On 7 January 2011, Sani Khatun, a Bangladeshi girl, was shot and killed by the BSF at India-Bangladesh border. The Daily Punjab published a headline, "Humanity is hanging on by a thread." I will speak, the publication of the photograph shocked the world's conscience. But SAC was silent and SAC was balanced. Is it brotherhood? Is it people to people concept? I will speak, I express my opposition in forward scope and answer to my question. Other speaker, drawing attention that according to the human rights law, more than 1,000 civilians have been killed by the Indian border guards in the last 10 years. The violence inside it did not stop, even after permissions by the Indian authorities. That is why Adil Rahman Khan, the Secretary of Odisha, told the BBC, the border between Bangladesh and India has become the bloodiest one in the world.
The Deputy Leader of the Opposition, you had questions or you can say all those things in addition to what you were otherwise supposed to say. So please say all that you have to say.
Today our motion is search from its birth has achieved more payload than success. I am strongly opposing these motions for some reasons. First of all, search is in its own track to implementation of some sectors and some means, like agriculture, tourism, technology, science, commerce, etc. Then, first of all, let us focus on agriculture, in which agriculture jumps on nutritional balance, nutritional food, food banks, food availability, etc. can be exchanged by SAC Agriculture Information Center in 1988. Then, in communication, SAC has helped in telecommunications, study tour, skills, information, everywhere. First of all, in communication, SAC has achieved more success through communication, telecommunication, skills, information, satellites, etc. And again, SAC flight exhibition in 1985 is working for SAC satellites, which is expanding and harmonizing. Then again, SAC is helping in education, culture, sports, etc. Now you can see that South Asian poetry is working on anthology on South Asian countries. Like, they are working on culture, they were working on tradition. They are expanding and harmonizing their traditions. Again, South Scholarship Team, South Yacht Awards, South everything is working on those. Then, coming to the drug abuse of SAC in their sector. SAC Convention Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances in 1991 is working for ratification of drug abuse. Drug offenses, monitoring deaths is also working for drug abuse. Now, SAC Travel Guide, SAC Tourism Hotel Management is working for tourism sector of SAC. SAC is working on women's empowerment, that is women's development, women's trafficking, children affairs, children marriage, etc. is being reduced by SAC to the member states. SAC Traffic Journals is also working for violation against women in Ken SAC Summit. Now, as the government team has said, they are failing to give their support in their sector summit. So I would like to say that they are expanding their areas on economic areas and trade areas. Like Committee on Economic Cooperation of 1991, Intergovernmental Group, Intergovernmental Expert Group, SAFTA, they are working on this development in 2020. Now I can say that Shakespeare of 1996 with the theme Cooperation on Economic Growth. Now focusing on summit, Honorable Speaker, I'd like to say that the first SOC summit on 1985, second SOC summit in 1986 ensured survival protection development of children rights, women empowerment, human rights. By signing MOU in 1993, SOC cooperating with international agencies like UNDP, UNICEF and also UN. Seventh SOC summit also includes SAFTA as a main framework of SOC. The head of the state is also recognizing their main framework as SAFTA. The 16th SOC summit held in 2010 resolved tackle to climate change and sustainable energy technology that is electricity. The 17th SOC summit that is in recently time 2011 is 7th SOC is signed 4 agreements. 1. Rapid response to natural disaster. 2. Multilateral element on response. Then implementation of regional challenge, etc. 9.12% global economic is raised by SOC. Honorable Speaker, I would like to give some example of initiatives taken by SOC, like SOC Audiovisual Exchange Program, 1987, SOC Theme for Promotion of Organized Tourism, 1987, SOC Cheers Fellowship on 2016, SOC Asian Festivals, etc. According to my statement, Jenny, do you think that the Indian Pakistan Paris demolish SOC? Will SOC be demolished? So thank you to my Honorable Speaker.
May I now request the member of the Treasury Bench?
Our Speaker, she has spoken about some institution of search. But our Speaker, I think he doesn't know that maximum institution of search has been closed in Nepal, Bhutan, India, Bangladesh. So the success of this organization is totally failed. Our Speaker, the Prime Minister, along with another foreign minister, has perfectly mentioned the failure of search from its birth. Now I would like to tell them it's a two parts. That's to respect the principle of sovereign equality and territorial integrity, and not to interfere in internal affairs of other countries and mutual benefits. Our Speaker, now take the point of sovereign equality and territorial integrity. It's a matter of great sorrow that the sovereign equality and territorial integrity are almost absent in search countries. Our Speaker, for your attention, I would like to talk about Jammu and Kashmir. There is hardly any person who doesn't know about Jammu Kashmir crisis. It has been a burning question since the partition of India and Pakistan. Our Speaker, according to the Ananda Bhagat Patrika, about 100 or more people are killed every year for Jammu Kashmir issues. Here, let me question our Speaker. I would like to ask the opposition, who are search has done with Jammu Kashmir issues? The state country search has almost failed to restore territorial integrity. Our Speaker, at the moment of crisis, the role of search can be proven for the lines of stakeholders, the rhyme of ancient mariners, nor base nor motion, as idle as a painted ship upon a painted ocean. Yes, Honorable Speaker, here search is a breath, search is a motion, search is a painted ship. Our Speaker, I would like to draw your attention that search speaks of non-interference in internal affairs of other countries. But as a member of search, Pakistan can boldly violate the objective of search. Khan started the trial and punishment of the worst criminals of 1971. Pakistan commanded negatively on the matter. It's a kind of interference of internal affairs of Bangladesh. But such a challenge, how is it possible? My opposition holds the rule of search against Pakistan. I accept your answer of my question. Our Speaker, search takes up mutual benefit in its objective. Now prove how much false it is. Our Speaker, according to the civil newspaper like the Daily Prathamalu, Daily Star, Juganto, and my TV channels, about 22 districts of Bangladesh are well affected by flood. Still, 46 people are suffering. According to the 7th September 2007, the report of the Daily Prathamalu, Bangladesh has become a world to face the flood crisis because of its good preparation and help from UNDP. Our Speaker, Search could have given his helping hand to us, but it's a painful matter that Search has not brought any benefit to us. From my opposition, it must be proved that the mutual is totally proved to be vain, totally proved to be false. Our Speaker, from the point of view, once again declared that Search is a failure, which is swimming in false homeless ocean of inability. Our Speaker, in Shakespeare Macbeth, the heroine Lady Macbeth said, all the perfumes of Arabia will not fit in this little hand. Like Lady Macbeth, I would like to quote, all the success of Search will not hide its failure at all. Our Speaker, we have to go to international court for the negotiation of sea boundary dispute against India and Myanmar. We are 9,863 kilometers area. Here, Search has not kept any contribution, though it could have done it. Our Speaker, as Search desired territorial integrity, but cannot achieve it. Here, Search can be compared to a puppet. There is no life at all. So, I call Search a nominal association that has shown failure one after another. Our speaker, we all know that Bangladesh's agreement with India on forest cover barriers in 1996. But India doesn't do so as the agreement says. Red India blocks water in dry season and unlocks water in rainy season. For this reason, flood resists us every year. Our speaker, I would like to draw your attention that both Bangladesh and India are the member of SERC, but how in India neglects the objective of SERC, what does it do? Our speaker, SERC has not been able to serve the respect of sovereign equality. SERC has not been able to keep territorial integrity. SERC has not been able to win mutual benefits. Our speaker, as a member of governing party of this parliament, I would like to declare once again that the motion presented by the Prime Minister SERC from its birth had achieved more failure than success. And to prove and establish the motion, she has divided the goals and objective of SERC into 6 points. And firstly, the Prime Minister has extended first 2 points. And secondly, the foreign minister has already extended second 2 points. And lastly, I have highlighted last 2 points with theory, information, and logic. And to prove and establish the motion presented by the Prime Minister is also to be closed at this parliament. So keeping strong aversion in favour of today's motion, I would like to finish my presentation.
No.
I want to say that Rohingya is the problem of Myanmar rather than Bangladesh. Yes, Bangladesh is helping the Rohingyas, but Bangladesh is helping as a country itself. SERC has nothing to do with it. If SERC does anything, that would be a moral development of SERC. Now, as I was saying, our team has already shown many steps taken by SERC in different sectors, but those are not all. Environment was also identified as an area that called for the urgent attention of SERC in 1987, for which the heads of state decided to commission a study on causes and consequences of natural disaster and protection and preservation of environment. Moreover, another national study which was consolidated into a regional study was greenhouse effect and its impact on the region, which was completed by 1992. In rural development, the committee was credited for developing SERC Youth Volunteers Program, or known as SYVOP, in 1986 for engaging regional youth for harnessing food security, etc., through cooperation. ShelterNet was also established by the committee. Moreover, SERC has also taken some initiatives in rural development, such as decentralization in 1986, design and appraisal of agriculture and rural development program in 1989. Moreover, SERC has also signed an MOU with CIRDAP, or known as Center on Integrated Rural Development for Asia and the Pacific, in 2015. Moreover, SERC has also done various steps to elevate the women who were once thought as a burden in the society, who were once neglected, who were once undermined. Now, one of the most important features was designating 1990 as the SERC Year of the Girl Child, 1991 to 2000 as the SERC Decade of the Girl Child. Moreover, SERC has also signed MOU with UNICEF in 1993 and UNIFEM in 2001. Simultaneously, the 6th SERC Summit accorded the highest priority in the alleviation of poverty in South Asian region and decided to establish an independent South Asian Commission on Poverty Alleviation, or known as ISA-CPA, consisting of the member countries. Not only this, but SERC has also some regional institutions who are working day and night to promote the life of the South Asian people, such as SERC Agriculture Center and SERC Meteorological Research Center in Dhaka, SERC Tuberculosis and HIV-AIDS Center, SERC Information Center in Nepal, SERC Disaster Management Center and Documentation Center in India, SERC Regional Cooperation Center and SERC Energy Center in Pakistan, SERC Forestry Center, SERC Development Fund in Bhutan, SERC Cultural Center in Sri Lanka, and SERC Coastal Management Zone Center in Maldives. From all these examples that I have already mentioned, we can easily know that the member states of SERC has equal participation in SERC, and it is not a pocket organization. They mutually take some steps and try to fulfill the objectives of SERC. Moreover, Honorable Speaker, there are also some recognized bodies of SERC, such as South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation of Architects, SERC Federation of University of Women, SERC Cardiac Society, Association of SERC Speakers and Parliamentarians, Association of Management Development Institutions. The funny thing is, I'm not still done. There are some agreements on regional conventions too, agreements on establishing the SERC Food Security Reserve, SERC Regional Cooperation Convention on Suppression and Terrorism, SERC Convention on Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances. There are also 6 SERC regional apex bodies, such as SERC Chamber of Commerce and Industry, SERC Law, SERC Federation of Accounts, South Asian Federation, South Asian Initiative, to End Violence Against Children's Foundation of Stark Rights and Literacy. So, Honorable Speaker, if we sum up today's debate, if we summarize today's debate, we can easily know the Stark Discussion Organization, which works for the common interests, common issues, and common problems of its member countries. To solve the crisis between member states or the political problems or the internal affairs of SAARC is not mentioned in the SAARC charter or objective. Then why are you mentioning that again and again? Again, they have also mentioned about Rohingyas, which I have already mentioned in my speech earlier. They have also said that there is no international organization with SAARC, which is totally wrong, because SAARC is dynamic, because many international and regional organizations are working with SAARC, such as UNICEF, UNDP, UNDCP, IGU, CIR, DAP, UNE. So, Honorable Speaker, if we evaluate today's debate, we can easily see... 15 seconds, please. So, if we...
Okay.
Thank you. So, if we evaluate today's debate, we can easily say that our logic is more heavier, our logic are more concrete than theirs. We have shown many examples that SAARC is a success rather than a failure.
This is the first round of the debate on the issue. Now we will have a rebuttal round, as you all are aware. The first would be the leader of the opposition will get 3 minutes to rebut all that they have said so far.
They have told us various cases where SAARC has failed. But the key is our positions, our examples was more concrete than theirs. Their consolidation was not proper. We can say we have shown you, as I have told, why are we opposing this motion. We have to also shown you various sectors where SAARC have worked, various institutions, various organizations, various places. All the member countries of the world are totally working for its own satisfaction. They are not working specifically. They are working for the unity of their own South Asian region. SAARC is the organization which makes the whole South Asian region into a stronger region, which can fight with any other region of the world. It is the binder of the South Asian region. All the countries of the world are trying to collaborate with SAARC because they know how important it is for the economy and other sectors which bind the whole South Asian region. And it also gives them the power to fight with other regions of the world. If we say that they have told us there is no unity among the countries, we can say, if there was no such platform, such as SAARC, in the whole world, in the South Asian region, how would countries discuss their problems among them? This is the sectors where countries meet at least once a year, after 6 months, or any time, to share their problems. If there was no such organization, the problems among the countries would increase to lot, and at last it would want to war. Such as the problems of different countries, we can say. They have told us about the Rohingya problem of Myanmar and Bangladesh. We can say, if we say Bangladesh has helped the Rohingyas in a contributed and humanitarian way. But if we say that Myanmar is also a part of different organizations such as ASEAN, did ASEAN do anything to eradicate the problem of Rohingyas? No, it didn't Honorable Speaker. If there, because of the Rohingya problem of Bangladesh and Myanmar, whole SAARC organization is a failure, then we can also say ASEAN a failure organization. On the other hand, they have told us a girl was killed, the girl who was killed in the border of India and Pakistan. We have already said that no political issues or border conflicts are a part of the charter of SAARC. Then how can you say SAARC a failure for such a thing which doesn't even include its working arena, Honorable Speaker? Then they have said about the India-Pakistan conflict. If there was so much problem among India and Pakistan, why didn't Pakistan demolish SAARC? Why didn't India demolish SAARC? So then know their importance. Why didn't other member countries of the world demolish SAARC? Because they know its importance. Bay of Bengal, which is one of the most important parts of the whole world, is situated in the Southern Asian part, which covers the arena of SAARC. And it is the strongest point why SAARC can never be a failure. Geopolitics is the backbone of the success of SAARC, Honorable Speaker. On the other hand, they are saying there is no working arena of SAARC. Who has done all these institutions in the world? Who has done these organizations? For example, we can say...
Time I'm afraid is
15
up.
Seconds, please.
10 seconds.
Okay. For example, we can say that the institution in Delhi, who has done it? SAARC. They have empowered women. They have done so many things. If we concrete today's debate, we can say, in spite of their...
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول
مقاما محمودا الذي وعدته إنك لا تخلف الميعاد
هي الله এই পরিপূর্ণ আহ্বান ও শাশ্বত নামাজে তুমি প্রভু হযরত মুহাম্মদ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লামকে দান করো বেহেশতের সর্বোচ্চ সম্মানিত স্থান এবং সুমহান মর্যাদা আর তাকে অধিষ্ঠিত করো শ্রেষ্ঠতম প্রশংসিত স্থানে যার প্রতিশ্রুতি তুমি তাকে দিয়েছ নিশ্চয়ই তুমি প্রতিশ্রুতি ব্যতিক্রম করো না
explain so many things. If we conclude today's debate, we can say, in spite of their opinions, our opinions were more concrete, our opinions were more strong.
I now request the Prime Minister to please come up with a winding up speech.
If CERC becomes able to reach its maximum goals and objectives, then we will say that CERC has achieved more success than failure. But if CERC fails in maximum goals and objectives, then we will say that CERC has achieved more failure than success. But on the speaker, we have been disheartened. Our opposition has stood against us only for opposing. They are totally failed to show any recognized instances, data and theory and information. They should have been presented the success in fundamental objective and goals, but they are totally failed to do so. On the other hand, we have proved today's motion, including its fundamental objectives and goals, with theory, logic, data and information. On the speaker, if I question today's house about the success and failure of CERC, the house must reply, CERC has achieved more failure than success, CERC has achieved more failure than success, CERC has achieved more failure than success. Speaker, as per the first objective of CERC was to encourage active collaboration in economic, social, cultural, technical and scientific fields. If I question today's house, what is the achievement? The house must reply, nothing. CERC has achieved failure to strengthen collective resilience. Speaker, if I question today's house, is CERC successful or failed here? The house must reply, CERC is failed here. On the speaker, if I question about another four objectives of CERC, the answer will make only one sound, that is failed, failed and failed. On the speaker, if I question to this house, what is the achievement of CERC after 32 years of establishment? The house must reply, CERC has gained failure, CERC has gained failure, CERC has gained failure. On the speaker, even then my opposition has tried to show some little success in the bottomless sea of failure. On the speaker, they have spoken about SAFTA. On the speaker, in this agreement, it is to be said that all the custom duties on traded goods will reduce to 0% by 2016. But on the speaker, we are living in 2017, but still now we are exporting products on high custom duties. On the speaker, my opposition has highlighted the summit of CERC, but they have forgotten about the last and central summit of CERC, where Bangladesh and India rejected their participation. On the speaker, my opposition has mentioned some closed institutions of CERC. On the speaker, five closed institutions of CERC are CERC Meteorological Research Center, SMRC, stop. CERC Forestry Center, SFC, stop. CERC Documentation Center, SGC, stop. CERC Coastal Zone Management Center, SCZNC, stop. CERC Information Center, SIC, stop. On the speaker, it is a matter of great sorrow, pain, shame and failure that maximum institutions of CERC have been closed now. On the speaker, the success story of my opposition is so little that is not able to prove the success of CERC at all. On the speaker, I would like to conclude my speech with a funny story. On the speaker, once a Frankie's boy told his father, "Father, father, I have passed the exam." Hearing this news, the father became so much delighted and he went to his son's school to collect the academic transcript. On the speaker, he took the academic transcript and looked at it. But alas, his son got 33 in only one subject, failed in 9 subjects out of 10 subjects. On the speaker, the father became heartbroken. Yes, on the speaker, this result of the boy can be compared to the achievement of CERC after 32 years of establishment. We are now just like the heartbroken father who was delighted firstly and disheartened lastly. On the speaker, the failure of CERC will come again and again. On the speaker, throughout my speech, I have proved the notion that CERC from its birth has achieved more failure than success with theory, logic, data and information. So after all consideration, it is obviously and vigorously proved and clear that today's motion has exact potentiality to be passed at this parliament. Thank you, Honourable Speaker, fellow judges, my opposition and all the present.
CERC has achieved more failures than success. Failure is never achieved. You suffer failures and you achieve success. So there should have been some care taken in the nomenclature itself. And finally, about CERC itself, it depends on how you look at things. You know the old story of looking at a glass when you see it half filled or half empty. Personally, I am an incorrigible optimist and I see glasses half filled rather than half empty. CERC has definitely not achieved a lot of things that it should have achieved, should have been able to achieve, but because of the historical baggage of India and Pakistan, not just Kashmir and Jammu, it's also long before the people coming here and occupying part of the country. This is a very sad baggage that we carry, and that is why we are not achieving a lot of success that we should, but still we should not let it go. And that is why even Pakistan and India, despite all those exchange of fires, bombing and all those verbal abuses to each other sometimes, do not dissolve it or does not withdraw from it. So let us keep it. I know you have said by 2016 we should have achieved zero duty, but we have achieved some reduction through APTA and SAFTA and all those things. We failed in the road connectivity, but then we have left Pakistan and naturally Afghanistan because it is on the other side, but we now have BBIN. So if you cannot have a full ton, let us have a few kilos, so we are having BBIN. Let's not, for debate's sake you will say it, but let us keep it and let us try to make it as much active as we can, though it's going to be very limited. And I must thank both this government side and the opposition side for their very beautiful points, made very passionately sometimes, and almost like a politician. Thank you all very much, and I must adjudicate my honourable, I must thank my honourable adjudicators, very learned people, and I'm sure the results they have given must be well thought of. But please remember that this result, though it is justified because they have decided it, does not necessarily make the losers inferior and the winners superior. You all are equally good, equally efficient, but it happens that one has to lose some day and will win some other day. So with these few words, I now announce the result. Please get ready for the shocker and the pleasure. Incidentally, the government side has won today. It is Mojid Zarina Foundation School and College, Shariatpur. You are the winners. The other side here in this debate are losers, but they are no less good speakers and good argumenters, and I'm very happy with both of you. With this we finish today's proceedings. Thank you all, and final thanks to my honourable and learned adjudicators. Thank you all very much.